What's happening, everybody? Trey here, joined as always by my dad, Sean. And today, reactions to the classics. We got a song battle. We got two modern day artists, pretty big in the music landscape. Of course, we got Taylor Swift, who's one of the biggest artists of the past 10, 15 years. And we're going to be looking at her song, The Archer, from her latest record. And then we're also going to be taking a look at Grimes and her song, Delete Forever, from her record that just came out this year. So I'm looking forward to this one, y'all, and how this is going to work. I'm going to put a comment down below, in the comment box so put a thumbs up if you're digging the Taylor song more, or put a thumbs up for the Grimes. And this comes courtesy suggestion from our patron Levi. So Levi, appreciate you.
Thank you,
man.
Levi.
Looking forward to this one. And, I don't know either of these, songs.
I don't either, man.
And, I don't know. I mean, I know some of Taylor's biggest stuff. I don't know if I, know anything by Grimes.
I don't know anything from Grimes either.
I've heard her name. She's kind of been big with the critics for a little while here, and she's married to Elon Musk of Tesla as well. They had a kid recently, so that was in the news. But looking forward to diving into this one.
Sorry, the way the song battle works is we're going to listen to both songs. We'll comment about each song after it's over, and then we're going to pick what we think is the best song.
Absolutely, man. We're going to start with Grimes' Delete Forever. Here's what she had to say about the song. She said, "It's a pretty bummer song. I guess it's kind of about the opioid epidemic. I've had quite a few friends pass away. In particular, one friend when I was 18 passed away from complications related to opioid addiction. Artists keep dying and stuff, so I wrote this song on the night Lil Peep died because I just got super triggered. Lil Peep and Juice WRLD, which Juice WRLD also passed away recently, were both artists I really liked. The artist it's happening to specifically feels a little too on the nose. I think they were people who, in my opinion, were best expressing issues of mental health. So to have them die specifically just feels like a weird hopelessness." So I
gonna
be a heavy song. So looking forward to hearing this, y'all. We'll give our thoughts at the end here. And thanks again to Levi.
Thank you, Levi. It's gonna be a fun one.
Different type of vibe than I expected, man. But I'm digging the kind of guitar laden. Now we're getting beat rock a little bit. All right, Delete Forever by Grimes. I don't know if this, you know, type of style is what she normally, I mean, this came out this year, 2020, yeah. But if it is, I can see how maybe Billie Eilish took a lot of influence by her just by the delivery and yeah. style and whatnot. But I enjoyed that one. I liked the acoustic kind of lead, and then once the chorus got in, got a little bit more upbeat, I guess, in a sense. And then just the message of the song was very very powerful. What you think of it?
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, I'm just kind of right there with you. I did like the diversity in yeah, vocal delivery, and there was some change ups in there. So I did like that, man. Yeah, pretty heavy subject.
I like the chorus. I see everything. I see everything. Don't you tell me now that I don't want it. But I did everything. I did everything. More lines on the mirror than a sonnet. I like that line, you know, yeah, kind of reflecting the, you know, what I think, more lines like cocaine on a mirror.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially, and then, cannot comprehend, lost so many men. Lately, all their ghosts turn yeah. into reasons and excuses.
Yeah, I thought verse 2 was really good.
Innocence was fleeting like a season. I was digging this one, man. You know, that's going to be a tough one to beat for me, just for the message behind it and whatnot. And now we're going to go to The Archer by Taylor Swift from her latest record, Lover, that came out in 2019.
Yeah, she said it was her favorite song on the album. It wasn't mm-hmm. released as a single, but it did chart as a single mm-hmm. because that's the way things are nowadays in downloaded and streaming music. But she just released it first because she said, this one is my favorite. It's the one closest mm-hmm. To my heart.
So. Yeah, and it also follows this theory that I was just made aware of, where the track number 5 theory, which surmises that some of Swift's most vulnerable emotional tracks are the 5th track on their respective albums.
Yeah, so, I read that too.
This was number 5 on a Lover. So it looks like we're going to be hitting a little back-to-back heavy tunes here, man. So let's see what Taylor comes with on here, and then we'll give our favorite track. What's gonna win this song battle?
Combat, I'm ready for combat. I say I don't want that. What if I do? 'Cause cruelty wins in the movies. I've got a 100 thrown out speeches I almost said to you. Easy they come, easy they go. I jump from the train, I ride off alone. I never grew up, it's getting so old. Help me hold on to you. I've been the archer, I've been the prey. Who could ever leave me, darling? But who could stay? Dark side, a search for your dark side. What if I'm all right here? And I cut off my nose just to spite my.
Definitely hitting those strong lyrics that I expect coming in, man.
Together again, 'cause all of my
All right. The Archer Taylor Swift. So that's a song that, again, packed a punch there.
Yeah, it did.
This time more going on, obviously, the relationship side of things. Some of the insecurities there, talking about how all her enemies started out as friends. I thought that was kind of neat.
I did, too.
And it just had, again, that kind of electronica, just, you know, dance-like beat kind of underneath, but it didn't ever...
it never went totally in.
Yeah, hit the beat drop type of thing.
But and it supposedly interpolates lyrics from Humpty Dumpty, which...
Well, I noticed that, you know, where was that? I noticed that at one point there.
Yeah, me too. All the king's horses, all the king's men couldn't put me together again.
Yeah, there it is, because I immediately thought, I was like, Swift, you're putting a little Humpty Dumpty stuff in here, man. Her voice was very high in the mix, very clear.
Yeah, I like that. I thought that's how it'd be in a song this personal, because she obviously had some high-profile relationships. Plus, when you're this big of a star, like making a relationship work has got to be next to impossible, just because is that other person genuine? And then, you know, do they really want me for me? And then also, I'm traveling. There's just so many complications that... I would not really want to sign up for that.
And the way that she kind of utilized the whole Archer thing, I've been the Archer, I've been the prey.
Yeah,
so
she's been both.
You know, maybe the one ending the relationship and getting it ended on.
And who could ever leave me, darling, but who could stay? So there's just no win. She kind of sees herself, I think, in a no-win situation.
Yeah, and then they had the cool little production effects with the I see right through me. That was kind of in the background.
Yeah.
Just a pretty catchy, emotional song there. So that takes us now to the song battle, who came out on top. Man, both songs I was impressed with.
Yeah, I think Levi did a good job of matching these two against each other.
Because they both deal with, you know, kind of heavier emotional topics.
For
They both have kind of similar. I mean, the Grimes track, I liked the music behind it a little more, just because it switched up. The vocal style, I thought Taylor probably edged out.
I did too. I agree with that so far.
Just a little bit. So then it almost comes down to a preference of, you know, just one or the other based on the content. Are you going to go more for the Grimes talking about, you know, the opioid epidemic and the trouble of that, or you going with the Taylor Swift talking about the relationship? So this is a tough one, man, but if I had to choose, I'm just going to give the slight edge to Grimes with Delete Forever. So that's my vote, man. What about you, Dan?
I thought you were probably going to go that way. It's so razor thin for me too, as well. Like you said, like you couldn't have matched a hardcore lyric song, a serious lyric song, with something that just was kind of, you know, superficial.
Yeah.
So very good job of matching. I'm actually, Trey, going to go the other direction slightly.
It's
very close, man. I'm going to actually go with Taylor Swift, which surprises me going into this, but I never heard either song. I thought they were both really, really well done.
Well, as I mentioned at the start, y'all, I have two comments down below. So, you know, give a thumbs up to which one you were digging more, and we'll see which one comes out on top. And don't just vote T Swift because she's the more popular one either, you know. But
Either way, half of you probably going to be upset with one of us, so hey, man.
But, man, that was a fun one to do. Thank you so much, Levi, for, you know, constantly supporting us.
And, yeah, man. Thank you very much.
Really enjoy doing these song battles. So let us know what you think of these tracks as well, just in general, down below. Any other suggestions, we are open to them. And until next time, y'all, thanks for watching. Happy listening, and we will see you.